to al jihad is not something that is يعني bloodthirsty thing and no mercy and so harsh. No, no, no. Al jihad is a mercy. Like for example, your son when he wants to put his hand on the stove and the stove is red, he's heated. He wants to no. If he insists, no, you use this violence that will be for his own sake. Al jihad is using violence in the battlefield, but for the own sake of the person who will say the two shahada. And to show you that it is a mercy that at any point of time in the battlefield, that person that had the intention and he was striving to kill me in the battlefield, in the war, if it's time for me now, I have the upper hand and I can kill him, for example, now. If he says, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمدا رسول الله, he became a brother. Do you understand? It is haram for me to kill him. He became a brother. I can take precaution. I can take off his arm. I can, let's say, maybe imprison him or put him somewhere. In the end of the battle, the Khalifa or the responsible will see his case. But can I kill him? No. And you cannot say he said it just to be saved from killing. Did you cut open his chest to see what is in his heart? Do you know his intention? No, Allah knows. And apparently he said the shahada, he's a brother, khalas. So jihad is something that is very honorable, is merciful. It's a mercy for humankind. If somebody wants to jump from the 10th floor to die, you use violence to protect him out of mercy for him. So how about someone who's insisting to go to hell until no end? Who's saving him? The Muslim. How? By teaching. And sometimes if he doesn't listen by teaching, Allah Ta'ala made al-jihad lawful out of mercy for those people. Islam is great, Sheikh.